Sasha Banks, and then me and her had a match against Nia and Tamina, and I barely did anything. Like, Sasha just like ran around and was like fucking up with some of the other things, flipping around and was like, hey, guess what? Shoot, I thought of a thing. And then we won. And I was super stoked about it. I thought it was awesome. We got to do like a little double team move. It was in a break spot. I don't know if they showed it in the like replay or whatever, but like we did a thing where like I like sent Tamina into our corner, and then I tagged Sasha in, and then I like slingshotted her into Tamina, and she did like her knees, double knees thing, and then she slingshotted me to her, and I did like my flying elbow thing, and then we both did like a snap mirror like together, like a double, I don't know, what do you call that, 2 horsepower? So we did the 2 horsepower. And I totally like fell off, like I did like fell off balance and like into the turnbuckle, but I think I kind of played it out as I was just like, oh my god, this is so cool, like I got to do like a double team move with Sasha, which, you know, Bailey was totally jealous. Okay, she was. Oh man, you know, there's a contender for the best hugger in the business. Secretly, I'm fantastic at a hug. I go pelvis in, tuck it in. So the match was awesome, and then Charlie was interviewing us afterward, and by the way, I'm just completely against like after fight interviews in general, because you are at your least intelligible at that time and you're getting asked really fucking complicated questions, you know, that are going to be really heavily quoted and watched, and I kind of need a minute sometimes.
Do you want to participate in a Royal Rumble match?
Well actually one of like my dreams in the WWE, like when I first started, like when I first came here, one of the things I really wanted to do, to like, I don't know, I just felt like I would never be able to prove to anyone that I actually like knew how to wrestle and in a way that wasn't just like memorized from beginning to end, unless I could like, if I was like, if I'm the first one out in Royal Rumble and I go all the way to the end and win it, then nobody could say that I don't know how to wrestle. That was like, to me, the most difficult thing that you could do, like in my mind, like that's like, man, if you go to the Royal Rumble from beginning to end and win, or not even just to win, just go to the beginning and to the end, you know, the whole time, I feel like that's like the peak of being able to like say that like I can really fucking do this, so that's something that I always really really wanted to do, to just kind of prove that, maybe just to myself as well as everybody else, because even if I did that, I would prove shit to a lot of fucking people, because people are dicks, but to myself, I think. But maybe that's just revealing my very unrealistic expectations of myself and the things I need to do. Like, you know what? You don't know how to wrestle, and then you can go to the beginning or the end of the rumble. But for some reason, I don't know why, it's something I always wanted to do. But it'll probably never happen. I don't know. We'll see.
At Royal Rumble, you're facing Sasha. So what about Sasha's style that makes you want to face her and work with her so much? Is there something specific?
I don't think it's so much Sasha's style as like everything that she brings to the match. I mean, I love her wrestling style, and I think it's like really, really unique and like really distinct, and you know, her personality comes out in how she fights, which, you know, I think that's like, when you fight people, it's like having a conversation, you know, and she's got a very wide vocabulary. Like, she has a lot of different moves, so she makes up new stuff all the time, but it's not just like spots and stuff like that, but like, She just has so much like intelligence in the ring. Like she's like a real just fanatic of wrestling, like an encyclopedia. Like I imagine that, not that I imagine what she fucking does with free time, but I'm just saying like, I'm pretty sure that the second that she leaves, like actually wrestling, she just goes home and watches wrestling nonstop until she goes wrestling again. You know what I mean? Like that's kind of like what I picture, like what she does with her free time. You know, like don't you kind of get that vibe that like she's just like 100% obsessed with it, and so it's just like, you know, I understand having an obsessive personality about things. A, so I like her, and B, you know, I just feel like of all the women wrestling right now, she's the most knowledgeable, not just of like history, but like she's such like a fanatic in how matches work and how much you put them together, and like. I don't know. It's like, it's like a weird kind of like, I want to say like a weird, like, she's just like a savant in a way that doesn't take away from everything else. She's just really fucking awesome at this one thing. You know what I mean? One of the things that I more feel like is one of my weaknesses is like, I say all the time, like, I can play an instrument, I'm not a composer, you know, but I think that she's, like, a wonderful composer, so I'm just like, dude, I can play the fuck out of a bassoon, like, just write me some bassoon music, and, you know, it's, and with any, like, fight, and in any sport, and anything that you do, you know, like, the performance is only as good as, like, your dance partner, you know, like, the greatest judo matches of all time, my best, you know, matches in judo, my best matches and, you know, my best fights in MMA, and I don't know, it's just, it really depends on who you have out there, and like, if I could go out there with somebody, like, if I had a judo match with somebody that I could do anything to and throw them around or do whatever. Like I had matches where I feel so bad for the other person now thinking back at it, but I would be like at a local tournament and like I needed matches, like I needed reps. And so like I could just walk out and beat people right away in a second. So I would try and get as many reps as I could out of them. And so I would try to like do just enough to not beat them, you know? I would throw them, but then I would do a big throw, but then like stop at the very end, make sure they fell on their butt for like a smaller score. I would get them in a pin and then I would let them out. And I would get an arm bar and let them out, get another arm bar and let them out, get him another arm bar and let them out. And it just showed all the million great, great things that I could do, but it was a shitty match and a shitty experience for the other person. And you know, I got more experience out of it. But you know, I think that you need to find somebody that really pushes you to that extra little bit where it's like, if I'm just rolling around with somebody, I can be thinking about something. Like I used to get songs stuck in my head all the time when I was a kid and I was grappling, and I'll get songs stuck in my head and I'm doing all this stuff. And if I'm with somebody who's just like not challenging me at all, like my mind could be off into Belize and I'm just like, oh, you know, going through the motions, and I'm not like actively engaged in what's going on. And so like, if I try something and the other person has an answer to it, then I have to think of another, if I answer their answer. And then if they have another answer to that, then I'm kind of like going down this chain of answers where I have to actually think, you know, I have to have an answer for something. And I think that she has so many answers for so many of the things that I could do, that she is the kind of person that can like push me to invent something on the spot. You know, like there were matches where I did like flying armors, this, this, that. And I'm like, I don't even know what just happened. I don't even know what I just did. I just know that no one's ever done it before. And I won't be able to replicate it because I don't know what just happened. But it's because of that opponent put me into a situation that I had never been before and pushed me into a thought process that I had never had before. And suddenly we have invented a new thing. Right. And we have done something super awesome and everyone is stoked, you know? And she's the kind of person that I think has so many of the answers to so many solutions that I would try to come up with that she would push me to a level that nobody else has before. I was not trying to be like poignant or whatever with that. I just got really thirsty by the end of that spiel. I wasn't trying to be like the Kermit, like.